we damage the natural resources. It may be air, it may be water, or it may be soil. Share our profit with the nature, with the society, with the poor people, because we have used the resource, government. So we should not cheat the government. We should not fraud the government. So we should have to pay the proper tax. Total performance equals to net income plus human resource contribution plus public contribution. So total performance equals to net income. Hello, my dear students. I am Rajay Sir, Faculty, Department of Commerce and Management, Vidyashram First Year College, Mysuru, a temple of excellence. My dear students, in today's session, I am going to handle the subject Corporate Accounting 2 for 4th Sem BCom, and the topic is Social Responsibility Accounting. My dear students, what do you mean by Social Responsibility Accounting? So, our social accounting, we'll call it as a social accounting also. So, here, so if you have heard CSR, Corporate Social Responsibility, Corporate Social Responsibility. Why we are coming up with Corporate Social Responsibility? See, in order to establish business, in order to produce a product and reach the product to customer, so we use natural resources, and also we know we damage the natural resources. It may be air, it may be water, or it may be soil, or it may be sound pollution. So without polluting natural resource, without polluting natural resource, we cannot produce any products. So without polluting, we cannot produce any product. At least there will be some minimal pollution will be there. So in order to, because we are giving huge burden on the nature, so we are putting huge burden on the nature. So even though it is a minimal effect, some companies, but if you compare to other companies or in other developing and underdeveloped countries, so they are putting so much of pressure on the nature. So by polluting the natural resource, or it may be water pollution, air pollution, noise pollution, and other types of pollution. So because of these things, sometimes atomic energy, so there also atomic energy also radiation we are, so by using the atomic energy, so we are polluting. So, and also we are giving radiations to the nature. So these things affects the nature, affects the society at a large. And also in order to bring this, so we had to compensate the nature, no? So by using the nature, natural resource, by polluting the nature, we are producing the products, we are doing the business. And what in return, what we are giving to nature? So in order to reduce our pollution, in order to, we have to give back to our nature. So giving back to nature means giving to society. So giving to poor people. So giving to the last person in the society, the poorest person in the society. So by giving, so by rendering some service, by doing some, by developing or by providing some natural development, and also say like planting trees and bringing some, so how to reduce the carbon in the air. So how to increase the forest cover, and also by providing education for free education for the poor people. So in order to reduce the risk on the society, on the environment, so whatever the pollution, whatever the pressure we put on the society, for society and nature, so by through corporate social responsibilities, we can reduce or we can give back to nature. So by taking everything, resource from the nature, we are producing, we are doing business. So ultimately, out of the profit we earned from the business, so we should keep some amount to give back to the nature and society. This is called as corporate social responsibility. But yes, we are producing or we are getting the profit and we are spending on corporate social responsibility. So to maintain this, bring this or to increase the effectiveness of the corporate social responsibility, there is an account we have to prepare. So we have to keep a information. We have to prepare some information. So we have to give all, or we have to write all the information. How much we spend, how much benefits we are giving to the society, how much benefits we got from the society, and how much we are giving back to the society, to the nature, to the society, to the poor people. So, how we are managing our responsibility in the corporate world. So this thing has to brought to the books of accounts. These things, this information has to brought to books of accounts. This is called as social responsibility accounting. So how much we spend, how much we are using. So if we are not doing any books of accounts, if we are not having any account on which amount or on what things we have spent, so what is the benefit to the society? So there may be some chance to misinformation, so manipulation in the books of accounts, or maybe whatever the fund we are providing to the nation, it will not serve the purpose, it will not reach the poor people or society. That's why in order to avoid this, in order to use our funds in an effective way, in an efficient and effective way, so we have to prepare some accounts. So we should have the benefit, everything should be written in the books of accounts. That's why we need social responsibility accounting in order to calculate how much we spend, what is the benefit we got. Next one, social accounting or social responsibility accounting aims to measure and inform the general public about the social welfare activities undertaken by the organization. So here, yes, we are spending all the amounts to society. So we are raising funds through our business profit and we are spending. So yes, we have to provide the information to the government. We have to provide the information to the customers. We have to provide the information to our tax authority, government, our investors, our employees. So what we are doing, how we are spending, are we spending in the effective way, is there any mismanagement in resource? So those things has to, there should be an account, there should be a calculation. That's why we need social responsibility accounting in the books of accounts. All the information will be brought to the books of accounts. Ultimately, we will analyze those things and in a small social balance sheet, we will prepare a social balance sheet and give it to the higher authority, give it to the government, customer, general public, for everything. Everyone who needs the information will provide it. That's why we need the social responsibility accounting. So this is the information. So how we spend the amount. So how we benefited the society. So what are the benefits we got from society and what are the benefits we are giving to the society and nature. So this calculation will be brought to the books of accounts. Then it is called a social responsibility accounting and its impact on the society. So we have used the fund as social responsibility accounting and corporate social responsibility. So what is the impact by providing education? So we could educate 10 students, we could educate 100 child students. So and also we can reduce the child labor in the society, we can improve the health, we can provide the education. So how we are benefiting the society, what is the impact, ultimate impact on the society, that is very important. Next one, social accounting is defined as a process of measurement. So we have to measure the benefit what we are giving to the society and also reporting of the information to concerned authority and concerned higher authority, or it may be higher level management or the government or the any government agency. Next one, the term social accounting is a recent origin. So in earlier days there was no social, even though we had social responsibility accounting, but we did not give much importance on the social responsibility accounting. We were only concerned with producing the product and distributing the product, providing the service, that's it. But we did not think about the what is the effect on the society, what is the effect on the, so what are the bad effects, what are the good effects out of our business, what are the bad effects on the society and nature. So it is a recent origin. Now the new thinkers, new research has come up with the social responsibility or social accounting or corporate social responsibility. So we are getting the profit from the society and also we have to share our profit with the nature, with the society, with the poor people, because we have used the resource. Without resource we couldn't have produce the product. Without resource, we couldn't have do the business in the society. Customers are our resource. Poor people are our resource. Natural resource is our resource. So depleting the natural resource, using the natural resource, we are producing the product. So sometimes overusing, sometimes exploiting. So without exploiting the nature, we cannot produce anything. It may be goods or service. We cannot do business. So that's why we have understood that we are exploiting the nature. That's why we had to give back to the nature to reduce the burden on the nature. Next one. Nowadays, it's being organized that commercial evaluation of the business units is not sufficient. Already explained to you, just only producing and making profit is not sufficient. We have to look at the what is the effect on the society. What is the effect of the business on the society, on the general public in a indirect way to justify commitment of funds to a business unit. So only you are busy in calculating the profit to the, so having calculated the effects on the society? No. That's why so the modern thinkers and modern research has come up with the social corporate social responsibility. Rather than evaluating will be complete only if it takes into consideration social cost and benefits. What is social cost? That's why. So we have utilizing the resource. Sometimes we are over-utilizing or over-using. Sometimes we are exploiting the resource of the society and nature. So that's why we have to cost and benefit. So what is the cost of society? We are exploiting the society. It may be natural resource, it may be human resource, it may be without government, we cannot do the business. Without general public, we cannot do the business. Without nature, natural resource, we cannot do the business. So we are using everything. We have to at least some portion of the profit we have to spend or we have to share with the society, with the nature. So that's why in order to bring all this information under books of accounts, we need social responsibility accounting. Next one. So what are the social responsibilities of business? So now we understood why we need the social responsibility. What is the meaning of social responsibility? We have understood. But let's understand what are the actual resource or what are the responsibilities of the business. Now resource. So we have to use, we have to judicious use of resource. With minimum resource, how to increase the profit. Wealth maximization is very important rather than profit maximization. So wealth maximization includes our natural resource also. So we have to use minimal resource and we have to come up with maximum profit. So how to do this? Even though we are having abundance of natural resource, we cannot exploit this. We cannot exploit because we have to save it for our future generation. We have to save it for our future generation. If we use all natural resource, what about our new generation? Our children, our grandchildren have to live in the same society. If you destroy everything, if you overuse or if you exploit everything and you consume everything and leave the society in a damaged way, how they will live? How our future generation can lead their life? They have to pay the maximum cost. They have to pay some maximum expenses. It will be expensive for them. So if you use all the, if you degrade the forest, if you cut all trees, where our life only, in our life only, can we get the oxygen? So in order to grow the trees to that level after 20 years, 30 years, if you plant a sapling or if you plant a small tree today, so it takes 20 years, 30 years to it will become big tree and provide enough oxygen to the nature. So it takes 20 to 30 years to cover up all the geographical area to make it greenery. So cutting a tree is a half an hour, 1 hour matter, but to grow tree it takes years. So till then, whatever generation, new generation will do. So if you spoil all the water resource, so where our future generation will go for drinking water? So our drinking water is only just 1%. So 99% of the resource is salt water, but only 1-3% we are having drinking water. So 97% is a salt water in the earth. So in this 3%, so more than 60-70% is groundwater. It is in ground level, not in as a river. So we may having only 1% as a river water. So as a drinking water, so river and canal, river, it may be lake. So we are having only 1% or 1 or 2% of the water out of 100%. So if you destroy those things, if you overuse, if you leave your industrial waste to rivers and lakes, so where our animals will go? So for us only, for ourselves, where we can go for drinking water, good drinking water, So it is very, very important. So that's why, so we have to use judiciously resources. So it belongs to the whole world, to all employees, to all customers, to all, it may be future generation also, they are the owners of the resource, today's resource. So we have to save, we have to conserve the resource. That's why. So it is a responsibility of the business to use the various resources in a material, labor, capital, machines and management in employed by in the best possible way. So we have to minimize the use of resource. We have to come up with maximum of profit, maximum wealth to the society. Profit means wealth. Profit means benefit. Okay, not only in the monetary form, it may benefit in the any other way. So by increasing the education, by reducing the poverty level, by giving the our nature friendly products, by producing the nature friendly products, we can give back to the society. Next one, customers. So yes, so even though we are producing the goods for the customers, so we cannot exploit the customers. Exploiting in which way? So if you produce the product, if you leave your industrial waste to water, the customer will drink the same water, he will end up with some diseases. So it is like exploiting the customer's health. And also if you producing the products and you are leaving the carbon dioxide and nitrogen to the air, customer will breathe that unhealthy air, ultimately will end up with some diseases. So like this, even though we are producing the product, we should produce the product in an environment friendly way, nature friendly way. So we should encourage the customer to use those products which are nature friendly. So in today, developing country, educated, developed countries and developing countries, our educateds are refusing the products which are which are destroying the natural resource, which are exploiting the natural resource, and which are polluting the natural resource. So we should avoid, or we should oppose those products which are polluting our natural resource in a maximum or in a highest way. So without polluting, without exploiting nature, yes we can understand. Without polluting, without exploiting the natural resource, we cannot produce any products. But we can reduce it to the minimum level. So we can reduce it to minimum level. So and also we should provide the quality foods, quality products to the customers with a effective production techniques. Use the technology in a way, such a way that it should be reduce the pollution. So it should be reduce the burden on the society, burden on the nature means burden on the customers only ultimately. Next one, employees. So we have to take care of the employees. So we have to provide good salary, good environment, working condition for the employees. And also we should not exploit the employees. We have to come up with different benefits, not only in monetary way. So there are so many benefits. Without monetary way also, we can improve the satisfaction of the employees. So like this, the owners and management should be of the business unit should not be treat employees as a commodity. So we should not treat them as a slaves. So they are human beings. We have to respect them. We have to help them in a problematic situation. So we should take them their confidence. We should take their confidence in taking any decisions like that. Next, employees are not be treated as a machines. They are should be treated as a human being. We should provide the social, so physical needs, economic needs and social needs also. Next, government. So we should not cheat the government. We should not fraud the government. So we should have to pay the proper tax to the government. We should provide the proper information to the government so that government, once the government will get the money, where government will invest? Again, it will invest in the society only for the development of the society. For afforestation, they will use the money to reduce the deforestation, for afforestation. And also we also, from our money, from our profit, we can do afforestation. So also we have to, we can provide the education for the poor family background, for the education, free health facility for our employees, free health facilities for our customers. So it leads to goodwill also. It will goodwill for the company also. Next one, society at large. So ultimately, by doing good business, good ethical business, we can provide the, or we can provide service to the society. Next one, to identify and measure the contribution of all these things. What are the objectives of accounting, social responsibility accounting? So to identify and measure the and contribution of towards the society, what we are doing, how we are effectively using our funds to improve the societal differences, to reduce the difference in the society, to improve the coordination and cooperation in the society, and also to increase the health benefits, to provide the education benefits to the society, and also to nature. We can utilize the social information in the social responsibility accounting. Next one, to determine the firm's strategy is consistent with the social property. So to nowadays, all firms who are investing so much in the social responsibility, corporate social responsibility, so it leads to improving the goodwill also, it leads to advertisement also. So don't go to the TV, don't go to the print media for advertisement, do your social responsibility. So once the customers feel or felt that, yes, our company is taking care of our health, taking care of our education. So if whatever the profit goes to that company, they will share the profit with the customers. So ultimately, customers will come to you and purchase your product because, yes, they will understand transferring your profit to the benefits of the society, benefit of the customers, benefit of the general public. So it leads to improving the goodwill of the company. So once the goodwill of the company increases, ultimately we make still more profit. Next one, to make available relevant information about the firm's goals, programs and performance, use of the scarce resource. So by using the accounts, in order to we can compare our current year information to previous year information. So every year we should reduce the pollution, we should reduce the cost of the society. So we can improve the benefits to the society. So how can we can do that? So if you have all information books of account, we can compare with previous year. We can set a standard. We can set a standard and we can reduce the resource in a minimum way with coming up with maximum profit. Next one, the quality and properly present the social cost and benefits to the enterprise. So we can come up with the quality and properly represent the social cost and benefits. So how much, what is the cost of the society? What is the benefit for the society? So by my business, so I'm car producing business I'm having. So what are the cost for the society by production because of my business? So what are the pollution I'm doing? What are the pressure I'm putting on the society? So after I'm making profit, how much I can transfer that benefit to the society again back to the society. Like this we can discuss. Next one. Social accounting concept is relatively new in India. So even in developed countries, it is before 10 or 20 years only they come up with the social responsibility accounting. But in our country, developing world, so we are concentrating nowadays or in current years, we are concentrating on social responsibility accounting. Although this is very difficult to identify various social costs and benefits to the society and still more difficult to convert these costs to modern equivalent. So even though, so it is very difficult, how much pressure we are putting on the nature to calculate these things. So what is our actual, so where we are polluting the nature? So it may be noise pollution, it may be water pollution, air pollution, soil pollution, so many pollution, so many burden we are putting. So this is the social cost. Ultimately the customer, general public, has to bear the cost, isn't it? So it is very difficult, but to some extent we can calculate the cost of the social cost and we can come up with the social benefits. Next one, the UNIDO and the COECD have published the methodology for measuring the social responsibility accounting and social cost benefits. So yet in India, it is very few business have adopted the social responsibility accounting. Still, there is a huge scope in India to come up with social responsibility accounting. Next one, Tata Steel Industry Corporation. So was the first company to come up with the, to adopt in the social responsibility in India, and also so some of the other undertaking also started nowadays in a modern day. So many companies are come up with the social responsibility accounting. So but Tata Iron and Steel Corporation, so TISCO is the first company in India come up with the social responsibility accounting and CSR in India. Next one, so now what are the social accounting approaches? First one, classical approach. What do you mean by classical approach? So there is one and only one social responsibility of the business, to use its resources and engage in activities designed to increase the profit along its stays within the rules of the game, engage in free and open competition without depletion or fraud. So what is the main approach? This says is only use the resource in a proper way, judicious way. So reduce the mismanagement of resource or overutilization or exploitation of resource. So if you reduce the resource, ultimately it benefits the entire society. Next one, descriptive approach says social activities of a business are presented along with the financial statements in the narrative form. So what do you mean that social activities of the business are presented? So whatever the, when we prepare the balance sheet, financial statements of the business. So we have to adopt the what are the actual benefits and what is the social cost and what are the social benefits from our business. We should include that also. Next one, integral welfare theoretical approach. So integral welfare theoretical approach says this approach advocated by the preparation of a social report comprising the social benefits and social cost. So here, so we have to prepare the social benefits and social cost. We have to include this in the financial statements. So in a theoretical way. Next one, fourth one says social indicator. This approach involves the different areas of social contribution to be undertaken by the business. So different areas means what? So providing education. So education, good water, clean water for the poor people. Providing clean water for the poor people, providing the good education for the poor people, and also by planting trees and all, so by sampling, by reducing the, for example, if you are producing the motor bike industry or motor car industry, so how we can, by reducing the carbon dioxide, by reducing the other, you know, toxic air in our car, so by coming up with electricity, electrified car, by bringing the electrified car and with a minimal cost, you can also increase the social benefit. Next one, total performance equals to net income plus human resource contribution plus public contribution. So total performance equals to net income, our income of the business, human resource contribution, how we can effectively utilize our human resource, and also public contribution. So what is the public is contributing for producing the product. Next one, environmental contribution. So what is the environmental contribution? What is the, what we are taking from the society? It may be good water. So we are polluting good water, we are polluting good resource, we are polluting good air and all. So what is, so this is the contribution of the environment. Next one, product and service contribution. So after production, our service, after our product, so how we are degrading the society, degrading the environment. So after, for example, plastic, after using the product, they will throw the plastic everywhere. So by bringing the dustbin throughout the society, so by implementing or from investing with dustbins, public dustbin, by constructing the public dustbin and public toilets, they can also contribute to the society like this. So total performance equals to net income. So how much we are providing to our human resource, how much we are providing to the general public, so how much we are providing to environment, and also how much we are providing our product and service are serving to the society. So these are including the total performance. Next point, Linnowitz operating statements approach. So here this advocates the preparation of a social economic operating statement. So here he proposes the social economic operating statement includes the tabulation of firm's expenditure for social benefits and statement social cost and estimated social cost of various programs and enhance the calculating the social contribution equals the social benefits minus social cost. So ultimately we have to calculate how much we have utilized from the society. So it may be human resource, it may be government, government policies, or it may be society, how the nature, the resource, how much we pressure we put on the nature to the general public. So we have to calculate in a monetary form. We have to calculate in the monetary term. After, for example, my cost. So whatever I got from the society, it is a cost to the society because of my business. So 1 lakh rupees to the cost, as a cost to the society. I have taken resources, I utilized human resource, I utilized the good water, I utilized the resource. So I, because of my business, because of my production or my product, so we have coming up with pollution to the society. It is a burden on the society. So this cost of the society is, so whatever I am doing bad things because of my products or because of my production. So without exploiting, we cannot produce the product, any product or services, without exploiting the society or nature. So what is my cost of that? It is 1 lakh rupees. So I should provide, I should know after getting profit, I should give back this 1 lakh rupees or 1 lakh 51 rupees I will do. So for 1 lakh 51 rupees, I will plant a trees. For out of this 1,50,000 rupees, I will provide free education. So I will provide good water to the society, poor people. So because we have polluted the water, that's why we are providing the good water to the poor people. So if you pollute the water, the poor people will drink polluted water, then they will end up with some diseases. So we can also provide them health benefits. Like this, we can do the social corporate social responsibility. Next one, measurement of social cost benefits. We have to measure it. So we have to already explained you. So we have to measure in terms of money. What is actual cost, social cost? So after that, how much I can give back to the society. So it is difficult to measure the precious monetary terms, the social cost. It is very, very difficult. How much pollution we have done? So can we, how much we have polluted the society, how much we have polluted the air, water, and how much, no, exploited our employees, exploitation of our employees. So we have to bring all this into monetary forms, then we can pay back to the society. Next one, following methods of criteria can be used for the measurement of the social cost and benefits of a particular project. So we can use these methods. How, what are the methods? First one, capital output ratio. So on the base of profit and output, our production, on the base of our production, we can, for example, for 100 units, this much is the social cost. This much is the social, for example, it gives an idea of the expected output in the relation to the capital investment in a project. As per this method, the project giving the higher output per unit of a capital employed is to be given preference over any other project. So for example, my investment is 1 crore rupees. So my investment is 1 crore rupees. Out of investment, how much I come up with? So if you invest 100 rupees, what is my returns? What is my profit? So we should accept the project. We should accept the project which gives more profit, more wealth generation, more profit generation, more benefits to the society. So by accepting the project which gives more profit to the society, we can reduce the cost of society. So we can reduce the cost of the society, because by minimum investment, by minimum utilization of resource, we are coming with maximum profit. So that once we get the maximum profit, we will reduce the usage of our resource. Like this, we can reduce the burden on the society. Next one, value added method. So what do you mean by value added method? The term value added may be taken as a follow, as follows. First one, sales value minus cost of budget of output inputs and raw materials and components, etc. So sales value equals to cost of bought. So cost of materials, what we have purchased. Next one, output, how much, production. Next one, raw materials we have used. Next one, components, etc. We can take this to consideration. Next one, it takes into consideration the net contribution made by the business to the nation's economy. So what is the, so after, because of our business, so what is our contribution? We are giving employment generation, we are giving the, we are paying the tax to the government, we are reducing the poverty in the society by giving employment, by giving good salary. So like this, we will consider. Next one, the project having the higher value addition is preferred. So for example the government has to accept the project or businesses, which project gives the higher value, so which project is beneficial to the society, which provides the more employment to the society, which provides the, which reduce the diversity or differences among the society, should be accepted. Next one, so in the next session, we will discuss on reporting of social cost benefits information and social audit is very important in the examination point of view. Till then, thank you so much.